hungry by and by. Well, by and by, oh, when the morning comes, all the saints have got together home, and we will tell the story how we've overcome, and we'll understand it better by and by. Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive,
alive forevermore.
Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, my Jesus is alive forevermore. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, my Jesus is alive. Oh, alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive,
alive forevermore.
Alive, alive,
alive forevermore.
My Jesus is alive. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah. Oh, my Jesus is alive forevermore. This is the day,
oh, this is the day that the Lord has made,
that the Lord has made.
I will rejoice, oh, I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it.
For this is the day that the Lord has made, I will rejoice and be glad in it.
Oh, this is the day.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Oh, I will enter His gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter His courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice for He made me glad. He's made me glad. He's made me glad. I will rejoice for He made me glad. Oh, laying up my treasures in this home above, trusting fully, trusting in my Savior's love, doing what I can for heaven's holy God.
Yeah.
that the trumpet's gonna sound so loud. And when we wake up today, and in the twinkling of an eye, back just like he said. Well, I believe the time is nearing when we'll see his appearing. Oh, this could be the hour, for this could be the day when the saints from every nation will lose their gravitation in the middle of the air, be called away. And I believe he's coming back just like he said.
Well, I believe that the trumpet's gonna sound so loud. And when
you wake up today, well, in the twinkling, eastern sky, and I believe it's coming back just like he said. Yes, I believe it's coming back just like he said.
Well, I believe that it's going to sound so loud
when we wake up today. Well, in the deep,
let's go. morning.
Oh, I'm going to meet you.
Oh, in the morning.
And I will meet you.
Oh, I will. Oh, glory, glory, glory. I
will
rejoice
for that glad
meeting with the saints
who for it.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, glory.
We'd like to say to Sister Stillwell's brother and his wife, Suzanne, that in service with us this morning.
Yes, amen. Oh, hallelujah.
It's good to have everybody here today to help us out.
Hallelujah. A brighter day is coming, right?
Hallelujah.
Just around the corner. Soon we're going to step on heaven's shoulders. Thank the Lord. We won't have to worry anymore.
Thank you.
to worry anymore.
Thank you, Sister Sandy, for that. Won't be very long, we won't have to worry anymore. Junior, we're going to let you go right now for Junior Church. Turn this over to Sister Elliot.
Praise God.
You help her preach this morning.
Yes, amen. Need all the help I can get. You know, we just don't even realize how soon the coming of the Lord is. Hallelujah. It's very, very soon, folks. Are we ready? Are we ready? We talk about it. Are we ready for the coming of the Lord? Amen. It's going to take much to make the rapture, but things are fastly coming together of the coming of the Lord. We know we said, well, you know, I know. We just kind of go on the same way we've been going and doing the same thing we've been doing. Enchalant, just a little unconcerned and whatever. But you know what? We need to take it to heart. The Lord is coming soon. Church, I want you to be ready. I want to be ready. I want every church to be ready. Oh, I want us in this church to realize what it's going to take for the coming of the Lord. And be ready, prepare every day. Spend all day, every day, preparing for the coming of the Lord. So good to see all of you here today. And the reason you didn't see any more of what you saw there, the juniors, their camp wasn't dismissed until this morning. I don't like that. I don't like that. I want them to dismiss on Saturday so they can be in church on Sunday, which needs to be. I don't know how much voice I may carry, but I'm going to let it be heard anyway. They have been up there since Wednesday. They've had a really good camp, and Foxy said the kids was just really into the worship and all, but the way I feel about it, they ought to be in church on Sunday morning. Amen. But we're glad you're here. It's so good to have Harvey and Alice here. Long time since I've seen them. So good to have you in the house of the Lord with us today. Back home, back in the nice beginning of the nice warm weather. Hasn't it been nice and cool for this time of year? I'll tell you for sure. God's good to us, isn't he? And his blessings are surely up on us. Amen. I'm going to preach a message this morning, the Lord helping me, and I need him to help me. I cannot make it without him. We cannot, any of us, do anything without the help of the Lord. Amen. I'm going to be preaching out of the book of Judges as one of my scriptures, the 7th chapter, the 16th through the 21st verses. I'd like to use as a title for my message this morning, Blow Ye the Trumpet. Blow ye the trumpet. We need to be getting people's attention. We need to keep our own attention. I'd like to read these verses of scripture. Then I'm going to say a little bit more about trumpets. Judges 7, verse and the 16 through the 21st verses. And he divided the 300 men unto three companies. And he put a trumpet in every man's hand. He put a trumpet in every man's hand. That means woman too, I believe. That means the children too. With empty pitchers and lamps within the pitcher. And he said unto them, look on me, and do likewise. And behold, when I come to the outside of the camp, it shall be that as I do, so shall ye do. When I blow with the trumpet, I and all that are with me, then blow ye the trumpets. Blow ye the trumpets on every side of all the camp and say, the sword of the Lord of Gideon. So Gideon and the 300 men that were with him came into the outside of the camp in the beginning of the middle watch, and then put newly set the watch, and they blew the trumpets and brake the pitchers that were in their hands, and the three companies all together, they blew the trumpets and brake the pitchers and held the lamps in their left hand and the trumpets in their right hand to blow withal. And they cried, the sword of the Lord and of Gideon. And they stood every man in his place about the camp, and all the host ran and cried and fled. Father, I ask you this morning to anoint your handmaiden as I speak the words that I feel that you have given me. Bless the ears and the hearts of this congregation today, and I will give you praise and honor and glory. Well, we find a lot about trumpets in these verses of Scripture here today. First of all, why a trumpet? What is there about a trumpet? Trumpets are used a lot, especially in Bible times, and even now is used in worship and celebration. Isaiah said when he blew the trumpet, blessed are the people. Trumpets, get your attention. You ever notice? When you hear a trumpet played, or the blowing of a trumpet, it has a clear, distinct, and a sure sound, and a commanding sound, a sound of victory. Amos said, shall a trumpet be blown in the city, and people be not afraid? Destruction threaten Israel and Judah. They were going in here to take this city. But as they were going in, there were trumpets that was placed in their hands. And Gideon said, the things that I do when I blow the trumpet, you blow, we're going to stand outside the camp. There is trumpets blown in time of battle. I want you to know, church, we're in a time of battle. If you don't believe so, you just get in and serve God with all of your heart. Refrain from the world and the compromise of Satan, and you will see what kind of battle that we are in. So therefore, we need to blow the trumpet, and blow it hard, as we would blow that, as it says here in the 16th verse. And we find that they all then, when they gathered around the city, they were going to take the city. They were in battle. They were in a crucial hour. We are in a very crucial hour. We can take those for God that we witness to. We can make sure that we are ready and prepared. And so as they blew the trumpets, they went forth. And then all of them together, and I want you to notice the words, what it said, they stood together. They stood as one with those trumpets ready to blow the pitchers and the lamps. And then they began to break the pitchers and to blow the trumpets, and they come in on the enemy. And it said that the enemy began to run all in one. Oh, set the trumpet. Oh, the people. There was a sound of caution in Judah that had failed God and that had gone back on the Lord. Isaiah says, in that day, that great trumpet shall be blown. I believe Gabriel already has his lips to the trumpet today. Oh, it's at our very door, and it shall be blown. All they that were ready shall worship the Lord thy God in the mount of Jerusalem. Jeremiah said, blow the trumpets and go into the defense cities. Let's blow the trumpet this morning and take the community for God. Take your family for the Lord. Take all of the accursed thing, the thing the devil is bringing upon the people today. And we can blow the trumpet in the name of the Lord. Oh, the watchmen, if they blow not, we are the watchmen this morning. If we blow not that trumpet, their blood is going to be required in our hand. John looked, and a door was opened, and he heard a voice like a trumpet say, come up hither, and I will show you the things that are to come. As I said, a trumpet, if you'll notice, was used in the distinct sound and the getting the attention of the people. Oh, you can almost hear the trumpet being blown. Oh, this morning, Revelation said, John the Revelator was in the Spirit on the Lord's day. He heard a voice like a trumpet say, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. Oh, I want you to know it's coming, it's coming, it's coming. Are you ready? Are you prepared? I mean not months and years, but the coming of the Lord is even nigh at our door. Joshua, in the book of Joshua, said, oh, the Lord told Joshua, he would give him the city of Jericho. Didn't God tell you that he would give you your loved ones? Didn't God tell you he would keep you with the victory? Didn't God tell you he would make a way where there seemeth to be no way? But there was a plan that God gave the people to take the city of Jericho. God has given us the plan today. He's mapped it out for us. He's made it plain. We can't deviate from that plan. We can't take some back roads. We can't take no detours. But we have got to go God's plan. And it said, oh, God told them to go around the city of Jericho 6 days, one time a day. And then he said, the seven priests shall go before the ark with seven trumpets. The seventh day they shall come past the city seven times. Seven is God's perfect number. The priest, after they obeyed the command, the people, after they obeyed the command and went around once a day for 6 days, on the seventh day, they went around 7 days. It says the priest shall blow the trumpet. We're on our last round, folks. We're on our last trip around the city. Hallelujah. We're on our last lap of that journey, Brother James. We're nearing the end. Then when they run around that seventh time, Casey, it said that they blew the trumpets. When they hear the sound of trumpets, don't want to be here to sit in this world. I want to go. Hallelujah. Sister Stillwell, there'll be no worries anymore. And I think of the song of Easter games we just sung. If you hasten up to glory, wait for me at the gate. Wait for me at the gate. I tell you what, we've got a lot of them in this church. I believe it's going to be waiting just inside the gate. I got a lot of my family up there. You got all your family up there. If you hasten off to glory, wait for me just inside the gate. And then the ark of the covenant went on, and they continued to blow the trumpets, and they took the city, and all that was in the city was destroyed, and they come into that city and took it over. Hallelujah. I say again this morning, Victory Tabernacle, we need to be blowing the trumpet. The word needs to be blown wherever we go. Oh, you know what? When the Bible tells us to go into the highways and the byways and compel them to come in. Didn't say wait for them to come in. Wherever you go, you need to be telling it. The Lord has impressed me this week to get my grandchildren together. I'm going to read the same scriptures that I'm reading here this morning. To be honest with you, I don't know if they've actually really heard those scriptures read all the way through. But if I do, and I want to do that, I want them to hear about what is going to happen. And then what is going to happen if they're not ready, and if they stay here. I feel like doing that. You need to get your kids. You need to get your grandkids. You need to get your great-grandkids, your friends, whoever. You ought to set a time and say, I want you to come. I want to read something to you, and I've got something I want to say. And just read those scriptures about destruction, but then what glorious resurrection and what's going to happen on the face of the earth and the things that are happening now. We all need to do that. Don't wait to do it. You may be waiting too long. Bible said in Isaiah, cry aloud, lift up your voice like a trumpet. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 14:7-8. For if the trumpet gives an uncertain sound, who shall prepare himself to the battle? We want to use the trumpet and not give an unsure sound. Be definite. Be with the anointing. Get out and do it. You can't just hope or think somebody else will. You get out and you blow that trumpet. Give a very distinct sound. Because if not, who shall prepare themselves for the battle if we do not do so? And in the book of Numbers, the 10th chapter and the 4th verse says this, if they blow but with one trumpet, then the princes which are heads of the thousands of Israel shall gather themselves unto thee. Just this last week we heard Brother Jonathan Kahn, I believe, who is the converted the Jewish man, that he talked, and I'll tell you what, he really stirred my heart. Those of you that missed this DVD the other night, he was talking about that all through time, every 7 years or the year of Jubilee, there was great things or events that took place, and he was talking, it hit right to the day, up to our day that we're living, and he was talking about the end of this last 7 year period. It's coming about in September. He wasn't setting any dates, but he was just talking about what had happened in the past. And he was talking, what if that this would take place? What if your hard-earned money, what if you went to the bank to get some money out of the bank, and they said your money is gone, the value of your money has gone down to nothing? You know what, we've got to have more than a bank account, we've got to have more than the worldly possessions. Oh, what if that was to happen at the end of a period that was the stock market crashed, and a ways there was 9/11 that happened, right to the days of every sequence. I can't explain it like he did, but it's come down to our time today. He said even as early in September was the end of that particular time. We don't know, and he doesn't know, and he didn't set a time, but there's one thing you and I do know, that it's sooner than what we realize it is. 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, the 15th through the 58th verse, says this. 1 Corinthians 15, 51 through 58. Behold, I show you a mystery. Are you listening to me this morning? The Lord is showing us a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed. How many's waiting till you change? Got to be ready. Got to be prepared. Nothing between you and the Lord. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. And we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption. And this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall we be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Oh, grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin. The strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, my beloved sister, my beloved boy or girl or whoever, that you may be ye steadfast, unmovable. Don't be wishy-washy that you're whoever you're with. Don't compromise. I appreciate what Sister Peter said this morning, as long as she's gone to church here and come here to worship, that we've not been a compromising church. And I appreciate that. And the help and grace of the Lord, we all make it that way. Not only the leaders, but we all make it that way. An uncompromising church. Be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, in as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. The disciples asked Jesus, what shall be the sign of your coming? At the end of the world, what shall be the sign? Do you know what the signs are of the coming of the Lord and the end of the world? Jesus said, take heed. Do you know what it is? Do you know what the signs are? Have you read it? The Bible tells exactly what the signs are. If you don't know, it's because you're willingly ignorant. Amen. Matthew, the 24th chapter, and the 5th through the 13th verses. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. How many knows that's being true today? On every side. Listen to me. Listen to what we teach. Listen to what we're doing. And you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. There couldn't be any more unrest. There couldn't be any more battles, chaos, and confusion in our nation, nations all around everywhere. Is very critical, it is very crucial and very cruel that we know the coming of the Lord is right at hand. Look what those are doing in countries coming into our country, trying to take America over. And they're trying to make our country, and they've done it to a certain extent, trying to make America as weak as they possibly can. And America is getting weaker and weaker. Our defense is getting weaker and weaker. We used to be the most powerful nation, but due to things that have happened along the way, we are very weak. For nations shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be famine, there shall be pestilence, earthquakes in diverse places. There was a tornado warning just the other night, just east of Flagstaff in Arizona. We had a tornado not too long ago in the Sedona area. There are things happening in parts of the country, in towns, that has never, ever happened before. All these are the beginning of sorrows. All of these are just the beginning of the sorrows. Let's remember that. And then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. And then shall many be offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another. And many false prophets shall rise, and shall deceive many. And because iniquity doth abound, the love of many shall wax cold. How many of you know people that one time was in serving God, they're backslidden today and watered things down? They no longer believe what they used to believe. They said there's nothing to what they used to believe. But he that shall endure to the end, the same that shall be saved. Are you ready to endure? What if they would come blasting in our doors? As those of you that stand for Christ, we are going to shoot in the head. We don't know, that won't happen right here. They're already telling that there is a bill that is going to be passed that if you preach any sermon on homosexuality, you've got to turn over to the government all of your sermons or anything that you preach contrary to the way that people are living today. They're glorifying all of this stuff. I'm telling you, when you watch TV, it makes you sick at your stomach. Some of the things that they are glorifying. And all like that. We know the coming of the Lord is so very soon. In verse 21 of that 24th chapter, then shall be a great tribulation. Such was not since the beginning of the world to this time. No, not ever before. 22nd verse, and except those, the day shall be shortened. There shall no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, those things shall be shortened. We better stay elect before God. We better stay true, because those times, for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened, because of our sake, because if we stood true and not compromised the gospel. And the 24th verse says, for there shall arise false prophets, false teachers, show great signs and wonders in as much that if it were possible, they would deceive the very elect. You keep your heart set on God, on the Word. Nobody can turn you around. Nobody can lead you astray if you do that. And then the 27th verse and the 29th, it says, for as the lightning shineth out of the east, and shineth even unto the west, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. In the 29th verse, and immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heavens shall be shaken. The 30th verse, and then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of glory. That's going to be a wonderful time. Then they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of glory with power and great glory. And he shall send his angels with a shout. There you go. With the shout of a trumpet. Then I'm going down to the 38th verse and I'm going through the 42nd. For as in the day that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered the ark and knew not until the flood came and took all them away. Too shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Then two shall be in the bed. One shall be taken and the other one left. Two shall be in the field, the one shall be taken and the other left. Two women shall be grinding at the mill, and one shall be taken and the other left. Watch ye therefore, you know not what hour that the Son of Man cometh. But know this, that if the good man of the house had known in which hour the thief would have come, he would have watched. Therefore, be ye ready, for in such an hour as you think not, the Son of Man cometh. You think what time that's going to be. You look in your house. Somebody in your household is gone. You give no explanation for that. They didn't show up. What about that time? Which is coming very, very soon. Hallelujah. High time, church, that you wake up. A little sleep, a little slumber, folding of the hands. Be ye therefore ready, for also the Son of Man cometh at an hour which you think not. Don't say anything about sin. That's the main part of the church world today. Don't say anything about sin. A loving God would not send anybody to hell. He doesn't. People send themselves. They say there's no such thing as the Holy Ghost. I mean, those that once believed. No doubt those that were once filled. What does the Bible say? An unpardonable sin. People will say, it's all about self. It's all about being a good person. It's all about glorifying what you do and believing in what you do. And if you think it's all right, it's all right. It's okay. That is a teaching of the biggest majority of churches today. You know what that is? That is a watering down of the word and a famine for the hearing of God's word. And when this happens, people will famish. We better accept the truth. We better preach the truth. We better talk the truth. Sin will not enter into heaven. Heaven is a holy place filled with glory and filled with grace. Hallelujah. People say, oh, I've heard this all of my life. They haven't heard some of these last time things that's happened. There's been some things happening that's never happened before. And just here of late, they have not heard it all their time. I'm going to tell you what. Say if this, none of this is true, which we know it is. But I'm just saying that if none of this is true, and you still believe, you've got nothing to lose. But if you don't believe, and it is true, you've got everything to lose. Gonna come. You might say, well, I've been to church all my life. I've been involved in the church. I've done this, I've done that. But still, you're not right before God. You can't make your brags and say, I'm this and I'm that and I'm something because of that. I'm going to make the rapture. I'm going to make it. But you need to know pin on some things that you could use for an excuse and think that it's going to get you ready. It said, behold, I come quickly. You must be patient. You must be established. Your hearts for the coming of the Lord draw nigh. He said, if you're ashamed of me, I will be ashamed. If we're ashamed of him, he will be ashamed of us. Amen. At the last judgment, the sheep is going to be divided from the goats. The Bible said those whose names were not written in the Lamb's Book of Life will be cast into a furnace. People say, oh, that's not literal hell. Lazarus and the rich man was no parable. Said there was a certain man. Those whose names were not written in the Lamb's Book of Life will be cast into a furnace of fire where there'll be weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth. Where the worm dieth not and the fire is not quenched. I want to know this morning, are you ready for the rapture of the church? It's about here. Either you're ready or you're not ready. Either you're going to go or you're going to stay. Heaven is a holy place. Filled with glory and with grace. Sin will never, ever enter there. Amen. Oh, the rich man had everything in this life. Father, come to the piano. Father, our musicians come. But yet, he died. The Bible said he went to hell. Lazarus died. Went to the bosom of Abraham. The rich man wanted Lazarus to come. If he could just come and dip his feet in cold of a hot, parching tongue. But there was a great gulf that was fixed that he could not come. There is a heaven to gain. There is a hell to shun. I don't care what preachers are preaching today. There are guidelines. We're saved. Given the Lord, are all committed to him. Everything that we have is the Lord's. And we'll keep our heart right before him every day. It'll be ready. However, but if not, I want us to stay on this morning. I want all of you this morning.
Deep.
Do you believe what I preached this morning? Do you believe the Lord's coming soon? What if all this takes place in the next month or two? Better be prepared. We don't know when. And I want you this morning, as I see something, you know, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that you're ready for the rapture of the church. I want you just to come. And if you know you're ready, there ought not be no hesitation. I'll just get right up and down to the front.
I think I
can. And I'll give you the promise.
Troublesome times are new. Filling his heart with fear. Freedom we all hold dear. Now is at stake. Humble your hearts to God. Save from the chastening rod. Seek the way pilgrims trod. Christians away. But Jesus is come. Morning or night or many will meet there too. Prophets will sound.
news will meet him in the sky. Going where no.
Some reason that you're not able to come, not able to walk up here, I understand. But for any other reason, it's not going to make it up here. Because of
your
physical condition, I want you to come.
I want you to come.
We shall
rise. Righteous for me in this.
door and all sides of us are coming in. Hold true to God. Hallelujah. It's going to be a great day. Great day. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That's the hope of the Christian. The hope of those that are ready. Aren't you glad for that hope that we have in the Lord? Amen. Praise God. I want us to raise our hands and thank God that we know that we're ready this morning. Father, I thank you that I know that we're ready today. I thank you, oh God, for these that have come. God, help us to make our calling and election sure. To make sure we're ready for that day. To come, Lord, soon. Help us to be ready and prepared. I thank you, Lord. I thank you and I give you praise and glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. A great day, but it is great to live for you. Great day to know you. Have the privilege to be a Christian. Let's take as many with us as we can. May the Lord bless you. One more time.
Well, I'm feeling mighty fine. I've got heaven on my mind. Don't you know I wanna go where the milk and honey flow? There's a light that always shines down inside this heart of mine. I've got heaven. Cause I knew the Lord had control, and I was walking and talking in the night. Cause I'd been on my knees in the night, and I prayed to the Lord, gave me a sign. And now I'm feeling mighty fine. Well, I'm feeling mighty fine. I've got heaven on my mind. Don't you know?